In this video, we're going to finish out the Understanding Geometric Diagrams and Notations worksheet. Our directions were to write if the statement given is indicated by the marks on the diagram. So we're going to pick back up with number 13. In number 13, we're asked if angle DCE is congruent to angle HCG. So locating DCE, here is DCE, and now let's locate angle HCG. HCG. Each of them have one arc indicating that they are indeed congruent. So this is given by the diagram. In number 14, we're asked if segment UQ is congruent to segment YP. There is not even point Q in this diagram, so this information is not accurate. So this is not given by the diagram. For numbers 15 through 18, we're told to list all information given by the marks on the diagram. So number 15, one mark given is 90 degrees. So we know that segment WV intersects segment XW perpendicularly. So our first piece of information is that XW is perpendicular to segment WV. Next, we can see that we have two separate single arrows. One arrow is on line XV, the other is on line UT. Therefore, we can say that line UT is parallel to line XV. And we're given two arcs and two arcs on two separate angles, therefore those angles are congruent. Angle UTS is congruent to angle UST. And that is all the information that is given in number 15. In number 16, we can see that we have two arcs around this angle and two arcs on this angle. So we can say that angle CDE is congruent to angle HGE. We also have a single dash on each of these segments. So we can say that segment DE is congruent to segment EG. And lastly, we have this 90 degree symbol, which means that this segment EF intersects segment GD at 90 degrees and is therefore perpendicular. So segment DG is perpendicular to segment EF. In number 17, we have an arrow on line EF and an arrow on line CD. So those two are parallel. We also have two arrows on EC and two arrows on FD. Therefore, those two lines are parallel. We also have a dash on segment EC and a dash on segment FD, indicating that both of those are congruent. So segment EC is congruent to segment FD. And lastly, we have a 90 degree indication. So we have that line DF intersects ray DC at 90 degrees and therefore is perpendicular. So line DF is perpendicular to ray DC. Number 18, let's look at all our parallels first. There are two arrows on line U and two arrows on line T. So U is parallel to T. Now let's look at anything that's perpendicular. Here is 90 degrees and line V intersects segment GF at 90 degrees. Therefore, V is perpendicular to segment GF. Now let's look at congruences. First, we'll look at segment congruences. There's two dashes on GF and two dashes on segment ED. Therefore, GF is congruent to segment ED. And for angle congruences, there is one arc on angle FED and one arc on angle CDE. Therefore, angle FED is congruent to angle C, D, E. Now, we're on to our critical thinking questions. At number 19, it says, draw and mark a diagram that contains two congruent line segments and three congruent angles. Now, I'm not expecting everybody to have the same diagram, but I'll show you a simple one that I drew. I need to have two congruent line segments, since I made this line the same distance away from this line, and these two lines I made parallel, then this segment is going to be congruent with this segment. So that takes care of my two congruent line segments. Now I just have to have three congruent angles, which, if you didn't realize, these three are all parallel. So when I have a line intersecting three of them, I can say that this angle, and this angle are all congruent. So I drew a diagram that contained two congruent line segments and three congruent angles. It actually contains even more than this, but that's all I had to label. You could also change the labels up. Have two dashes for your segments, and then I like to use dashes when making my marks on my arcs, but as it's been labeled in this worksheet, you could label it as two arcs. So there's many different ways to draw and label a diagram that contains two congruent line segments and three congruent angles. And also don't forget to label points. I'm just going to name this angle 1, 2, and 3, and I'll have G, F, E, and D. Number 20 says, draw and mark a diagram that has two perpendicular lines and four congruent lines. So you can see, this basically sums up a square. I have two perpendicular lines. Actually, I have more than just two perpendicular lines, because there's many different right angles, but I'll indicate these two. And I also have four congruent line segments, since the sides of the square are all the same length. And that wraps up the information and geometric diagrams worksheet. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions or are confused on a specific problem. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Each subscription is greatly appreciated and allows me to make more videos. Also, don't forget to like this video so I know that you found it helpful. The more likes I get on a video, the more encouraged I am to go further in depth on that subject. But again, as always, all subscriptions and likes are greatly appreciated.